This is Pav Bamber here for PSB Sports. I'm at the Gorman vs Accolade fight here at Crystal Palace. With me, I bumped into the white rhino himself doing commentary today. Dave Allen, how you doing, Dave?
Yeah, I'm very good, thank you. Pav, how are you?
I'm doing well. It's not often we see you at like an event commentating, so it must have been a good experience.
Yeah, it was the first time doing it. Went all right. I just said what I saw. Some people might not like it. I just said it exactly how I saw it. Some good fights on there, some not so good fights. Some good performances, some not so good performances. You know, I've boxed terribly in the past against Jason Gavin. I got all the stick in the world and I deserved it, and that's fair enough. So hopefully the people have to watch it back will agree with what I was saying.
What do you make of the main event in particular? Obviously your division, yeah. Gorman Accolade, was billed as many people believe it was to be a top 50 fight, yep, prior to the fight, but obviously Gorman ran away with about 8 points, so yep. How do you see it?
I saw it 9 rounds to 1 to Nathan. You know, I like Nathan a lot, I swag him a lot, I really like him. So I was a bit biased. On commentary I was a bit biased as well. But he did well. He hasn't got his man strength yet, he hasn't got his man power. He's winning things just on pure boxing ability. When that power and strength comes, it's going to be a scary proposition for anyone. You know, he won tonight easily. Dominic just couldn't pull the trigger, I didn't think. He just couldn't pull the trigger and he just got well beat comprehensively. And I'm not sure where Dominic goes, but I think Nathan now, be interesting where they do go with Nathan. You know, how fast they're going to move him, it'll be interesting.
I mean, in terms of, you know, the domestic scene, you've got so many young fighters there. You've got Gorman, your Accolade, Tom Little, yourself. You know, AJ Carter was always on the ball tonight. You know, Ian Lewison, you know, Dillian White. There's that crop of fighters there, and it's a real fans' favourite mix, isn't it? Because all these heavyweights can fight each other at any moment. You know, it could be explosive. It could be like tonight. But I guess the fans are the real winners, aren't they, Dave?
Yeah, there's a lot of good fighters there, mate. Like, yeah. I personally think out of all them, I think Dillian White's onto a level now. But all the rest of them, Ian Lewison for me is the best out of them. I think me and Ian Lewison, it could have failed to be a good fight, because Ian's going to try and take my head off. And people can say what they want about me, but I will try and take it off. Whether I'm very good at doing it or not, you know, that's not for me to say, but I will try my best, and Ian will do the same. So I've got a fight in Liverpool, we get that out of the way, and then we go to Bramall Lane, and hopefully, not that I'm saying I really want to fight Ian Lewison, but I just think that's a fight everyone else wants to see, so that's why I want it. If that's what people want, that's what they want. If people want to see me fight anyone else, I'll fight someone else. Whatever the demand is for, and whatever is what Eddie sees the demand as. If he sees that everyone wants to see me fight Ian Lewison, it's gonna put bums on seats, and it's gonna shift about 10 pay-per-views. Then I'm sure that'll be the fight that will happen. I don't know. We'll see. I'm happy to fight whoever. You know, I want a big name there. You know, a lot of people are calling me out, but I want a big fight, you know, and certain people are calling me out. I don't tend to see them as really big fights.
In terms of, obviously, with the relationship yourself and Eddie have, I mean, is it a contract with Matchroom you have, or is it just a fight-by-fight thing?
I don't think, most of them aren't contracted, you know, very few, very, very few are contracted, I think. So, just fight-by-fight, I keep winning. I keep fighting on the shows, and we keep this thing rolling. I lose,
but I mean, it's a great story. I mean, you know, the White Rhino project, yeah, with Dave Allen. I mean, from last year, since you fought Dillian White, you'd be fighting with Matchroom Bills, and Dave, you've literally just got bigger and bigger and bigger.
Funny though, because my two previous fights were on Matchroom Bills as well.
Yeah,
I've not fought on Matchroom Bill now for over 2 years, 2.5 years.
Do you remember when I interviewed you for Towers, but then you had to do for Gavin instead? I think that was a match on the undercard of Brit Busy as well.
Yeah, wasn't it? Matchroom Bill. The French champion before in October, so I've not fought on Matchroom Bill since August 2015.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm not gonna. I'm on there now because the thing's rolling. I'm not a great fighter right now. I know that. You know, I'm a domestic level fighter right now. But that's where I'm at, and I'm determined to get above that. I don't think that's the domestic level is not my ceiling. And I'm gonna prove that by fighting Ian Lewison, who I believe is domestic level's there. Ian Lewison's there. I beat him. I sit on the top of the domestic ladder. I don't know if that makes any sense.
No, it makes sense.
That's how I'm putting it.
So I mean, if you, as you mentioned there, if you had to pinpoint one name, you would want that Ian Lewison fight. If you
Ian Lewison's a fight I want, yeah.
Yeah.
I think everyone wants to see it. That's people ask me about Ian. I get messages about Ian Lewison every day. When you fight Ian Lewison, we want to see it. So that's what I'm aiming for. You know, there's a lot of good fighters at domestic level. You know. And hopefully we all we all improve and we all get to that level and we all fight each other. You know, I'm not fussed about who I fight, I'll fight whoever. We've proven that in the past. Like, I'm not going about who I fight, but now I've got to be a bit more sensible. I'm going to take the correct fights for the correct money, for the correct titles, for the correct whatever, to further my career and whatever else. You know, I've got to think now a bit more than I did before.
How do you see Joshua versus Klitschko going? It's around 4 weeks away now.
I think, I don't know. I can see Klitschko winning, I can see Joshua banging him out in a minute as well. It's one of them, you know, you can go either way, which I'm sitting on the fence of it because I'm really not sure how it's going to go, you know. I'm looking forward to it though. I'm really looking forward to it. I think one of them's going to get knocked out pretty early on.
And Hugh Fury as well goes out to New Zealand?
I'm going to watch towards Parker. Hugh's not been active. So I want to go towards Parker's a very good fighter. Hugh is a very good fighter. Going to New Zealand when he's not fought for 15 months is a very hard task.
Absolutely, and plans now for tonight, tomorrow, future? I mean, anything? I mean, are you fighting on Liverpool, is that correct?
Yeah, back home tomorrow, back in the gym Monday. You know, and we're looking for an opponent for Liverpool now. 6 or 8 rounds, not going to be anything spectacular. It's about just getting another win, a notch on the winning post. And then we go again. It's all about Bramall Lane. It's bad to say, but I'm not thinking about Liverpool. I ain't bothered about Liverpool. I want to fight. My dad's last fight, the only open air show on the Bramall Lane pitch was 1986. My dad boxed on it. If I can box on it 31 years later, you know, it's, I want to do it, and that's what it's all about. So fuck Liverpool. I don't mean fuck Liverpool. I mean, let's get Liverpool out of the way in a sensible manner,
yeah.
And then let's go to Bramall Lane and fuck shit up.
Yes, Dave. Dave, once again, thanks off your time for PSP Sports. Really appreciate it. We're going to keep on supporting you, and fingers crossed, many good things coming your way soon.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it. Thank you.